What happens when the government runs out of money? This is a likelihood, and it's scary to contemplate what would happen. In today's video, we're gonna talk about just that. I'm hoping the 50 cal on top of my apocalypse never needs to be used. One shot, now the future is yours, go! In all seriousness, what happens when the government has to keep raising the debt ceiling because they keep running out of money and they can't operate within a budget? Have you started wondering a little bit about why we have this hyperinflation and the choices that our government leaders are making, how that makes us look in relation to the rest of the world? Well, today we're talking about what happens when the government runs out of money. It's a very serious conversation, and it correlates directly with what you should be thinking about doing with your money. So let's start with this conversation of what is the debt ceiling? The debt ceiling is a limit that Congress places on the federal government to restrict how much debt in the form of loans the government can take out in order to fund things like welfare, the military, infrastructure projects. I want to be clear with you. The very last time our country was completely out of debt in our entire history was like a couple hundred years ago. It was for 2 years during Jackson's administration. But ever since then, we've only ever known debt. But how much debt can we really tackle? So for your information, we are currently $31 trillion in government debt. And like the global economy is like $30 trillion. So our debt, what we owe, is equivalent to like what happens in the year of a global economy. Part of this is due to some pandemic spending that we've had in the last couple of years. Part of this is also partisan gridlock. Like the right and the left, they are not doing a great job meeting in the middle. And yet we're going to face a potential government shutdown if we don't get the money that we need to even just cover our current budget. So it's kind of a mess out there. But when you liken this to a person's personal finances, do you know what it feels like when you yourself carry too much debt? There's a reason why Dave Ramsey exists. It's to like say, get out of debt, pay off your house, you know, get your credit cards paid off. There's only so much debt we can tolerate. And that is kind of the question, is how much debt can the government tolerate before we go under? Now, just so you're aware, we are in trouble, as in Yellen says that by June 5th, we're gonna be out of money. And if we don't raise the debt ceiling, then all of a sudden we might face a government shutdown. So this is a very hot topic. It's a very relevant topic, and it's one that needs to get solved right now. So what is likely to happen right now? On the left side, what's likely? On the right side, it's the less likely. So let's take a look at the left side. Shifts in the US dollar value. We know that we are losing value at the dollar more rapid than our 100-year average at a 3% loss to value on the US dollar. That's what depreciation normally is. Right now, this last 2 years, we've been between 5 and 9%. And because of that, what's happened is there's a lot of global mistrust about the US dollar because a lot of them have banked their dollar system and their financial security on the US dollar, which used to be seen as very, very stable. The debt ceiling will likely be raised, but not necessarily removed. There's definitely going to be some fluctuation in the bond markets. But the things that are less likely is an actual government shutdown. They always find a way to basically meet in the middle and say, oh, we agree to raise the debt ceiling, and then we have more money and more budget. But is that really sustainable? Can you do that long term? Which means that it's also highly unlikely that this lowers government spending. It's only going to be going up higher and higher and higher. So what does this mean for the economy? What does this mean for your personal economy? What should you be doing with your money right now? Well, check it out. The negative repercussions, there's a higher risk of recession. And I would say that we're 6 months into a recession. Musk and Bezos both agree that there's at least 12 more months of this before it comes to an end. We definitely are dealing with global distrust in the US economy. There was a number of countries that used to back their currency on the US dollar. They've chosen out of that. They're no longer doing that. And then obviously we have more political polarization. It's hard to believe that it can get worse than it actually is, but I got news for you, it's gonna get worse. Now, I tend to like recessions. I know that sounds a little cold, it sounds a little bit weird, but for me, I have to know how to financially be successful when the market goes up, when it's flat, and when it's going down. So let's talk about what you do to protect yourself. The debt ceiling crisis is edging the global economy closer to a recession. Here are your options. You can either do nothing, you can watch your savings disappear, or you can invest in hard assets like real estate ASAP. As in, if you just keep on waiting, your 401ks will keep dropping, your IRAs will keep dropping, anything related to the stock market is gonna continue dropping. Most of your finances are based on that model. If you look at what the wealthy do is they put their money in hard assets or businesses. Businesses that specifically do really well during a recession, they go up in value, they create more cash flow, and the wealthier get wealthier. For example, if you recall what happened during the last pandemic, we saw an increase of millionaires. How many? 5 million new millionaires entered that market. Why? Because business was succeeding. But what are the most of the wealthy doing, even the middle class? They're divesting hard in the game of real estate. Why? Because a soft asset like the stock market, IRAs, 401ks, they go down when there's a recession. Hard assets, things that are hard and tangible like physical real estate, they go up in value. Right now, real estate, hands down, is the most important place you can put cash. And if you don't know how to do that, check this out. People all over the world invest with me in real estate. I do all the work, they put up the money, and check out what happens. If you have, let's say, $50,000, for example, in a 401k, an IRA, or the stock market, or life insurance, or crypto, or something that has been tanking, when you put it in real estate and you average a 25% annual return, something very reasonable to do, this is on the low side of possibility, what happens over 20 years is it grows into $4.3 million. Remember, 90% of all millionaires do it in real estate. Real estate is a game that you want to find yourself in. And if you don't know how to do that, click the link below and you're going to learn about partnering with me. Partnering with me entails me doing 100% of the work. It means that you're putting up the cash. We become 50-50 partners. And people love this because it means that it's passive to them. They don't have to put in time, effort, and energy. And yet they're leveraging my experience on my last $2 billion worth of transacted real estate. So if you're thinking recession means bad news, think again. It could mean millions of dollars for retirement. And if you want to know whether that's true or not, click the link below and let's explore. You want to know why more people don't invest in real estate? Because there are 5 popular myths that keep people from doing it. And if you want to know what the myths are and how to overcome them, click right here, watch this video, let me show you.